We have another menstruation question. It's on longitude and latitude. The first one says that we should find the circumference of a latitude theta degrees north, where r kilometers is the radius of Earth. Well, that's quite easy. You find if you have this globe or the shape of the Earth this way, then of course you have the four cardinal points this way, which is north, this south, and this west, and this east. Now, the question says that we have a latitude at a particular point, let's say at the north, theta degrees north. Now it says that this latitude, of course, we have its own radius, which we call the small radius, always less than the radius of the Earth. So this is its own radius, which is small r. And the radius of the Earth is always bigger r. If you rule it out like this, you have it a bigger r. And the angle in between that is formed is a theta. Now, the question says that we find the circumference of the latitude. Now, how do we get the circumference of the latitude? Theta degrees north. Now, the radius of this small latitude is, the latitude is, if you want to get the radius, let's bring out this triangle. You have the triangle to be, this is smaller, and this is a bigger one. We have the angle. We have angle theta here. This is the angle it makes theta. So we have cos theta to be equal to adjacent over hypotenuse. So we have the smaller radius to be r cos theta. So this is the radius of the latitude, the parallel of latitude. Now, the circumference of the latitude will now be the circumference of the circle normally. Circumference, the formula is always 2 pi r. And this r here is the radius of the circle. So we have it to be 2 pi r cos theta as the circumference. Now, let's do the second question. We have a moving object take off from a turn P. And let's draw the globe again. No points. This is the north, this south, this west, and this east. Now I say take off from turn P, which on latitude 40 degrees north. So we have this to 40 degrees north. 40 degrees north, and then 52 degrees east. We have 52 degrees east here. So this is 52 degrees east. Now this is the point P. Okay, then I said it flies due east to any reach tan Q. So east, when it's here, it flies to east, obviously it's on the same latitude. So we take this where it flew to this place. That's a point Q according to the question. And then it then flies due north to another turn S. So it now goes from here and goes through north, that's on the same longitude, to turn S, latitude 60 degrees north, which is here. We are to 60 degrees north, and this is S here. Now the question now says that calculates the now having drawn this diagram of the globe, we want to calculate the radius of the line of latitude through P. Now this is the line of latitude 40 degrees north, and then the radius is calculated is according to what we derive here. We have the radius to be equal to r cos theta, and then accordingly to this question, we are given the radius of the Earth to be 6400 kilometers and pi to be 3.142. So our radius is 6400 kilometers. and then the angle theta is the angle they have in common, which is 40 degrees. So what's our radius? We have 6400 cos 40 degrees. You break, take a calculator and press it, you get 4902.68 kilometers. So that's the radius. That's the radius for the first question. This A question says the radius of the line of latitude of P is 4902 kilometers. Now for the second one, B says the longitude of Q correct to the nearest degrees. If you see Q is on the same longitude with S. So they said the longitude of Q. Now from P to Q, they have suppose the if we have of course we have P to be 52 degrees east at the longitude, but suppose we have longitude of Q, let's longitude of Q be, let's say it's alpha degrees east. Of course, it's at the east. But this longitude of Q is more than the one of P. And if they are on the same side, you subtract. You have east, you subtract. West, you add. West, you subtract. Now, what is the difference in the angle? We have the difference in angle. Difference in angle. To be equal to the bigger one is alpha, which is the one of Q. To be alpha minus the one of P is 52 degrees. So this is the angle, actually the difference in angle. Now how do we now get it? We have the formula for the distance. The distance will now be equal to, we have the distance to be equal to this angle for 360 times 2 pi the smaller angle because it's on the they have their com they are on the common parallel of latitude. So I've gotten this R, we have our pi to be equal to 3.142. So what do we do? We have the distance okay distance and okay Q PQ okay, we have distance PQ given according to the question. We said it flies through due east at 1450 kilometers. So distance PQ is 1450 kilometers. So if you put it there, we have alpha minus 52 over 360 times 2 times 3.142 times R is according to what we get is 4902.68. Will now be equal to the distance is 1450. So you have alpha minus 52 to be equal to, if you cross multiply, we have 1450 times 360 all over 2 times 3.142 times 4902.86. So you have alpha minus 52 to be equal to, you get the answer to be equal to 16.9. So our alpha will be equal to 16.9 plus 52, which is 68.9, and this is approximately 69 degrees east to the nearest. According to the question, so we should get the answer to the nearest degree, to the nearest degrees, to the nearest degrees. So the third question says you should find distance between Q and S along the parallel of latitude correct to three significant figures. Now look at the Q and S. They are on the same longitude, but they are on, they are on they flip towards and they are on towards the north. Both of them are north. So if you have the same size, we subtract. So north, we subtract. So what's the difference in the angle? Difference in angle, difference in angles. That's theta. Will now be equal to, you have angle 60 minus 40, which is 20 degrees. So since the distance is on, the distance actually is on along the parallel of latitude, and then they have the same longitude, common longitude, which is this longitude. So how do we get the distance? We use this formula, distance QS to be equal to theta over 360 times 2 pi big R. Why do we use big R? Is because of this common longitude that is shear, and this around the globe. That's the radius they have. The radius it will possess for this one is a bigger radius, which is from here to here will be the bigger radius with big R. So how do we do that? We have theta to be 20, or should we use another thing? Let's use gamma, so it won't be confusing with what we used before. Okay, gamma will be 20 over 360 times 2 times 3.142 times 6400. Okay, times 6400. We have the answer to be equal to 2,234 kilometers, and that is exactly the distance QS. So this is the question that we solve, and this is the solution. We appreciate you joining us on this. Is a e-learning platform. I hope you benefited a lot. And for you to benefit more, please post more questions and subscribe to our YouTube channel so you can watch more video. We like you. And if you like this video, please kindly thumb up by clicking on the like, so that we'll be encouraged to do more. And we also implore you to visit our official website, which is www.primetutorsolutions.com. Or you can also send your message to our Gmail accounts, which is primetutorsolutions@gmail.com. We hope to see you next tutorial video. Thanks for listening.